Make sure your jaw is soft. Long inhale. So again, to release, move the foot toward you. And we're going to end with a mobility drill. So you're gonna sit with your legs in front of you and the soles of your feet together. So make sure your feet are far enough away from you so that your legs look like a large diamond. So shift onto your left hip and internally rotate your right leg. Make sure there is a lot of space between your left foot and right knee. So know that you can use your hands if you need to. With your breath, inhale, come onto your feet. Exhale to the right. Inhale on your feet, exhale to the left. Couple more times. Inhale to the on your feet, exhale to the right. Inhale on your feet, exhale to the left. One more time. Inhale on your feet, exhale to the right. Inhale on your feet, exhale to the left. Long inhale. Reconnect the soles of your feet together. So before we do the other side, let's release your spine again. So this is called Kurmasana or tortoise pose. So aim your forehead toward your feet. What if your forehead does not naturally touch your feet? You can use a fist or two, or you can use a block. So make sure your forehead is supported. Smooth your forehead down to your nose. Soften your shoulders. Long inhale. Take another long inhale. Keep your head heavy. Contract your glutes. Curl your tail under to roll up. At the top, shift onto your right hip. Internally rotate your left. With your breath, inhale on your feet, exhale to the left. Inhale on your feet, exhale to the right. Couple more times. Inhale on your feet, exhale to the left. Inhale on your feet, exhale to the right. One more time. Inhale on your feet, exhale to the left. Inhale on your feet. Exhale to the right. Long inhale. So let's see if you can feel a difference. So we're going to end the way we began in double pigeon. So start with your left leg on top. So stacking lower legs, top foot slightly off bottom knee, top knee toward bottom foot. So notice if this hip, this pose feels a bit easier than the first time. Long inhale. So extend your legs in front of you. Pause here. And again, take a moment to compare your hips. So can you feel a difference? Maybe, maybe not. Then we're gonna come into the other side with your right leg on top. And again, checking in, it's gonna be right hip. Does your right hip feel a little less tight than the first time we did this? Maybe a lot tight, less tight. Long inhale. Okay, so let's prepare to rest in Shavasana. So know that if you have issues with your low back, you can use your chair by propping your lower legs. So take the time to get comfortable. If you have something for your eyes, cover them up. If you have a blanket nearby, cover up as well. So take the time to get comfortable. If you're wearing glasses, take them off. If there's anything in your hair, consider taking those off. And choose a position to rest in. So know that you don't have to be on your back. You are more than welcome to rest on your side or even your belly. Wherever you are, if possible, have your palms face up.
My heartbeat, 'cause you are the reason I'm losing my sleep. Please come back now. And there goes my mind racing, and you are the reason that I'm still breathing. I'm hopeless now. Just to be with you, and
Start to take longer breaths. Gently make your way onto the right side and take another moment there. Using your hands, make your way up into a seated position. When you can, place your thumbs on your sternum. Feel free to repeat out loud, silently, or not at all. I am peaceful. I am joyful. I am loving. Namaste. Thank you for joining me again. If you don't know me, my name is Riza, and I still am holding class at this moment. If you're interested, you can find my Facebook page. My company is called Wellness by Riza. And you can text me via Facebook Messenger. Thank you.